your boy Hugh here from Creator Up. Today, we are going to do an in-depth technical review of the Insta360 ONE R Invisible 360 Drone Mount for Mavic Pro 2. To truly understand the benefits of ONE R Drone Mount, we need to know how to capture 360 drone video and remove the drone in post-production without using ONE R Drone Mount. And this is still the professional way I would recommend if you use other 360 camera like the Coolcam AK, GoPro Max, or the brand new LED panel Pilot 1 right here, and other AK 360 camera review is coming next in February 10th.
So right now we're gonna do my professional setup. As you see the drone right here, I have a different Insta360 ONE R right here. And then this is my setup with the vibration damper right here. Hopefully you see it, the vibration damper right here. And then we just connect this part onto the drone. So as you see right here, we have two light GoPro mount connect to the camera from the vibration damper and the drone. As you see the camera shaking. That is, saw the vibration right here. It's for corner. But let's fly the exact same setup and see how good it's compared to the invisible drone. So now we have different setup right here. As you see the Insta360 ONE R on my vibration damper on my drone. And that is actually my professional setup. That's what I've been filming 360 VR for the past 3 years. So let's fly this and compare it with the invisible drone.
So here is the footage. As you see, it is really stable even without mocha stabilization. But you do see the drone, very big in the sky. I will show you the easiest way to remove first in Premiere. Click the export frame button here to export a PNG still frame. Open that frame in Photoshop. We see a pretty blue sky without any cloud and a bright sun. So we are going to match that with sky replacement techniques. This is a very quick demo. For a detailed tutorial on sky replacement, check this one out here instead. Go on hdrihaven.com, choose HDRI, and choose skies. And we see this one is a perfect sky to use to replace my sky. HDRIHaven is free, but if you cannot find your skies right here, you might need to buy them from other websites. Go in and download the 8K version as our video version is 5.7K. So you want to get the sky that is bigger than our resolution. Download it. Now open the HDRI file in PTGUI or any free HDR software. I like to open the panorama editor and edit the tone mapping to match my sky. Then click create panorama. Change the width and height to 5760 by 2880. Use TIFF format, click setting, make sure it is 16-bit per channel with no compression, hit create. Bring the TIFF file into Photoshop and put it on top of the screenshot layer. Now we need to align the sun location so your shadow look realistic. This is a very important step, so take notes. Hide the sky layer, drag a vertical guideline in the middle of the sun. Also, drag a horizontal guideline to find the lower point of your drone, like so. Go to Filter, Other, Offset, and offset the sky layer to match the sun location. Now show the sky layer and drag another horizontal guideline to meet the top of the mountain, like so. Click Add Layer Mask button right here, select Gradient Tool, and drag a gradient like so to create a gradient mask. Now hide the guideline, we just need to color match the sky. Create a level adjustment layer, right click and select create a clipping mask. So your color adjustment only affects the sky layer. Now adjust the setting until you match your sky. Now hide the original screenshot. Export the transparent PNG sky patch layer. Bring it into Premiere on top of the video layer As you see, the drone is gone. For more complicated drone removal technique, like using Photoshop or Boris Effect Mocha Pro to paint out the sky to have a more original looking realistic sky, please refer to this in-depth tutorial on step-by-step drone removal techniques. You can literally remove any size of drone in monoscopic and stereoscopic 360 video. The advantage of ONE R drone mod, post-production cost saving. So the biggest advantage of using ONE R drone mod is in post-production. You just saw how complicated to remove the drone in post-production, and it involves expensive software like Adobe Premiere, Photoshop, PT GUI, and even Mocha Pro or Mystica VR. In ONE R, it's as easy as drag and drop.
So right now, we're gonna fly the Insta360 ONE R invisible drone compared to my regular professional setup to see how stable this version compared to my version and everything else. So again, we don't have a GPS right here. We gotta go airy mode. So I'm gonna fly very be careful. Let me just make sure that I hold, don't chop my hand off, hold it right here. Yep, the lens is clean. Rise up, let's hear pretty constant speed.
Here we have the ONE R Studio software. I just dropped the footage in, we just shot. Check, use flow state stabilization, dynamic stitching, aerial addition, and chromatic aberration. And the aerial addition button is the magic button to make the stitching work flawlessly. Make sure you do not check log direction to avoid sudden movement. We control the reframing in post-production with smoothing instead. Then I hit the start export button, done. Bring the render into Premiere, you see the exact same result as before, without the drone. It's literally take me like 5 seconds and 4 mouse click. Think about the money and the time you can save in post-production. Stabilization comparison, Jello effects. Another big concern of FPV drone pilot and 360 videographers is stabilization. As right now, both lenses are touching the drone body directly without vibration dampers. So the image will take in all the machine vibration, which will create a Jello effect. The rolling shutter causes the image to wobble unnaturally. Let's do a quick comparison to show you. Here we see the two flights. The first one, we have the Insta360 ONE R Aerial Edition. Then we have my vibration damper setup, also filmed it with the Insta360 ONE R, the twin edition. Put them together, they both are invisible drone 360 videos, and both are very stable thanks to the full state stabilization. Look at the horizon line, they are a lot better than GoPro Max or Coolcam 8K. Both will need post-stabilization with Mocha Pro to achieve the same result. But if you pay extra attention, you can find the differences. I circled 3 spots on the ONE R Aerial Edition for you to look at. You see these yellow effects on the horizon line. Comes and goes. Let's zoom in 200% and see it better. Pay attention to the tall building here in front of the mountain. You see clearly this unnatural wobble caused by rolling shutter. Something that Insta360 really need to work on to remove the rolling shutter problem. The aerial edition is not the final production unit I have here, so there is a chance that Insta360 will figure out how to remove rolling shutter. But again, this is not an easy problem to fix. I would suggest also purchase an ND filter for the aerial addition to reduce the shutter speed and remove these yellow effects, a common solution really well known in the FPV community. Hey, if I help you, don't forget to give this video a like. Stitching distance. Since the two lenses are far apart, there is a safe stitching distance for anything filmed with the aerial addition. Again, since we do not have GPS, we should never get your drone too close to anything anyway. But as a good 360 videographer, this is the thing you should know when you are on the field, so you can position your drone correctly to capture the best seamless footage. As you see right here, the stitching distance is pretty large. I am standing 5 meters away from the camera and I am still affected by the stitch line. If you look at the pole right here, on your right, it is about 7 to 8 meters away from the drone and it is looking good. So in general, I push everything 8 to 10 meters away from the camera to avoid stitching artifacts. You should also pay extra attention to where the sun hit the camera. If the sun is hitting the camera around the stitch line, you will see this line of different brightness. So change the altitude of your drone to avoid direct sun hit on the stitch line. This is just the part 1 of the Insta360 ONE R Aerial Edition series. I hope it gives you lots of useful information that is not mentioned by others. All sample footage of this video are available to be downloaded. Check the link in the description below. Insta360 told me they would try to modify the Mavic Pro 2 setup to get a more stable GPS connection, so you don't need to fly in any mode. But as I mentioned, you do need to have the skill to fly in any mode, so you don't panic when you lost your GPS, like in an indoor flight or in a forest. In the next video, we will review the Mavic Pro 1 version, which will have the full GPS, and I will teach you some 360 reframe techniques as you saw in the introduction of this video, to recreate them step by step using only your mobile phone or inside Adobe Premiere. If you are new here, it would help me a lot if you subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bells for the latest tutorials on 360 production. Until next time, please fly safely and keep creating.